Okay, now we go deeper now into the thylakoid itself. So you got your chloroplast, then you got your thylakoid here. Now we go to the thylakoid membrane. So it is a membrane, okay? We are talking deeper, okay? I just want to put things into perspective now. You know the plasma membrane of a cell, right? Now you are inside the cells, inside an organelle, inside a membrane. So there are many layers of inside. This is super, super, super small. Okay, we are talking about maybe not nanometer, we are talking about picometer right now. So, so, so small. Okay, when talk about membrane, thylakoid is also a membrane. The important thing to know is that the thylakoid membrane contains this thing, the integral membrane protein, meaning that the membrane of a thylakoid, I enlarge this, okay? There is a protein in here. This is protein in here. And this is called the integral protein, okay? The membrane is made up of two lipid layers. So this is lipid layer, okay? And the lipid layer, when you enlarge this head and tail structure, phosphatidylcholine, you will have the hydrophilic region, water loving region, and the hydrophobic region. Okay, this thing here. So this thing here is arranged in such a way, there are some part will be hydrophobic, some part will be hydrophilic. This is important because hydrophobic region repels water. Okay, repels water, and it ensure that things do not get solubilized easily. Things do not get merged together, like the water, right? You have water, you put one color in, later you get a new color. Because water is soluble, it makes everything. So this hydrophobic region prevents that from happening, so that other structure can be present in it without being disturbed, right? Okay, so what do I expect you to know from here? Just that the fact that this is integral membrane protein. Some proteins actually only present on the surface. You only get here. Okay, some protein are only on this side. Some protein is actually attached like that. So you can imagine that the surface of a membrane, not only the surface of a cell, any membrane, is actually a very, very busy area. You have imagine that this table is the surface of a membrane. It's full of antenna. It's full of holes. It's full of gates. It's a busy, busy place. It's like, think of something. I'm thinking of a busy, maybe like a, you know some urban area got boulevard. By the side you got shops, and then suddenly you got your trash can. Suddenly you got your hub to wait for your Grab to come, and then there is a telephone to call the police in case you got chased by a bad guy, and then there is also a place for you to jump to the next boulevard. That kind of thing. It's a busy, busy place, okay? And that also applied to the thylakoid membrane. Yeah. And then look at here. This is the thylakoid membrane, this thing here, that gets even deeper now. Super, super zoom. Actually, scientists do not have the image, the actual image for this. This is like a model of it. They tried to get it, but the image still look fuzzy. I think they have the microscope now to get all the deep in here, but they reserve it for the NASA. They don't want to release the image for us. Okay, so this is a thylakoid disc. You see, it is connected. On the surface of the thylakoid disc, the thylakoid membranes, I want you to know these things. There are four proteins that is involved in the photosystems in thylakoid membrane. Four proteins: photosystem 2, photosystem 1, cytochrome B6F, and also ATP synthase. These are all proteins. Remember, you have learned about the photosystem, right? All is there. Photosystem 2, photosystem. What is photosystem actually? Photosystem is actually protein. It is a protein, okay? It's not a load one protein, no. It is a main protein structure, and then other subunit of other protein attached to it to make it functional, okay? So you can see in this image here, these are the labeling. Photosystem 2, one protein. Cytochrome B6F, one protein. Photosystem 1, protein. ATP synthase, one protein. Then you will see the dimer here. LHC1. LHC means light harvesting complex 1, meaning that this subunit of a protein is meant to be attached to, since the number is 1, is meant to be attached to photosystem 1 here. That's why the labeling become like this, the cartoon version of it. You have PS1 protein flanked or sandwiched by a pair of LHC1 dimer. Dimer means the subunit got two components to it. Di means two. Mer in science, mer like polymer, monomer, and so on. The word mer means building block or smallest unit of something. So it can be anything. Monomer, polymer, dimer, trimer, and so on. M-E-R, yeah? Not M-U-R. Murmur. That's not it. Okay. And another thing that you need to understand here about the localization of the protein. This is very important. Localization of the protein. You can read a bit more later. I can highlight here is that, remember that the lamellae means filaments, because this tubing looks like a filament. Lamellae. You got two types of lamellae now. Grana lamellae, stroma lamellae. That's what you have here. The middle region here is the grana lamellae. This, the one that is taking here. 1, 2, 3. Grana lamellae. Then you got the edge of it before you found the stroma lamellae. It's very important to understand here that photosystem and the other two proteins, the ATP synthase and cytochrome B6F, they have what we call as protein localization. Meaning that these four proteins do not appear randomly on the lamellae. No. They are actually concentrated in one places. For example, like this one, photosystem 2. Photosystem 2, you will find them predominantly in grana lamellae. This one here. This, what color is this? Petayap, kuning hijau. I don't know. Can I complain to this book? Do the proper coloring. Kau nampak apa? Mesti nampak. Tata lah, warna apa? How to call this color? This is green, this is also green. Grayish green. Grayish green, brighter green. Yeah. Bluish green. Okay, bluish green. So the bluish green, that is the photosystem to you, will see that they are only present in the grana lamellae. Predominantly, okay? But the photosystem 1, together with its associated light harvesting complex, LHC1, they are predominantly found in the edge of grana lamellae, but more and more in the stroma lamellae. Very important. Aku tak belajar kan sebelum ni? Sebab aku tanya pun aku tak ingat. Tak tahu. Yes. However, for the cytochrome B6F, in here, the, what color is this? Cyan? I call it cyan. For the cytochrome B6F, the cyan, you can see that it's pretty much everywhere. It's here on the grana lamellae, edge of granulomeruli, edge of granulomeruli, and also the ATP synthase. ATP synthase is also present in a random distribution. Okay, so why this is important? So that the energy transfer between these protein, by energy I mean electron, they are in the most efficient manner ever. Because this thing, all these photosystem, they will be activated somehow, meaning that they receive energy. In order to ensure that they get activated in the most efficient manner possible, they need to be positioned in the strategic location. That's the reason, okay? Imagine if, let's see, I can make a hypothetical situation as well. Okay, imagine if this photosystem 1, PS1 protein is located right in the middle of the folding here. Meaning that it's kind of dark and gloomy space in there. It will not have access to the final molecule, which is present in abundant in stroma. You see, photosystem 1, at the end of the road, it needs to pass the electron to an electron acceptor molecule. This molecule, by the way, it's called NADP+. P+. It need to pass eventually to this thing. This thing will accept and becomes NADPH. This NADP+, it's in the stroma. Stroma is this region. The what color is this? Yellowish, light yellowish region. If it's in here, can it have easy access to NADP? Not easy. Not easy. So inefficiency will occur. That's why the design has been in such a way, you photosystem 1 and your light harvesting complex stay on the edge of granulomeruli, or even better, straight in the stroma lamellae. Get exposed to the soup of the chloroplast so that when you are ready, send electron to NADP right away. And then you'll get your reducing molecule.